Now today we will be doing different angles, interior, exterior, corresponding angle, alternate angles, all these. Now when you know that when a line intersects, cuts another line, then that line is known as intersecting line, and the point where it cuts is known as the point of intersection. This is one point of intersection. Okay, so now if suppose you have two lines, two lines has been cut through a single line, then this line which is cutting both the lines is known as transversal. Okay, this line which is cutting both the line is known as transversal. Yeah, and in this case, this you make it since it's line. This is suppose P, so P is the transversal of the line L. This is line L. This is line M. So P is the transversal and LM is cutting two lines which are L and M. Now when they are cutting, you see there are different angles formed. Here is one angle formed, this is one angle formed, this is one angle, these all are angles formed, isn't it? These all angles are formed. Now I'll draw a bigger thing so that you understand. So these all are the, this is the P transversal, line L, line M. These are the, this is the your whole thing, P transversal is cutting two lines, L and M. Now what are the angles made? See, this is inside, this is the inside part, isn't it? This is the outer of the thing, figure. So this angle, I'm first marking the angle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. These are the angles marked. Now, if I ask you what are the interior angle, interior angle means which falls inside the figure. So these are the interior angle 3, 4, 5, and 6. So the interior angle is equal to angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, and angle 6. These are the interior angles. Clear? Now, if I ask you what are the exterior angle, then 1, 2, 7, and 8. Because it is facing outside, there is no other obstruction here. They are facing outside the figure. So, these are the exterior angle. So, exterior angle. Angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, angle 8. Okay. Now let's come to the corresponding angles. What is known as the, which angles are known as the corresponding angles? So 1, this number 1 and this number 5, they are corresponding angles. Okay, see if I again draw the figure. This is the figure and this is the line. This is angle 1 and this is angle 5 according to this figure. Isn't it? This is angle 1, this is angle 5. So angle 1 and angle 5 is one corresponding angle. Then again angle 2. This angle 2 and angle 6 will be again corresponding angle. Means you see, this is the corresponding angle. Again, if I move this side, it will be this 2 will be the corresponding angle. So let me write first. Pair of corresponding angle. will be angle 1 and angle 5, angle 2 and angle 6. Then which two? This angle 4 and this angle 8. We have marked this angle 4 and this angle 8. So this angle 4 and this angle 8 will be angle 4 and angle 8. One more we will have this one. This angle 3 and this angle 7. So angle 3 and angle 7. So now I hope you have understood what are the corresponding angles when two lines are cut by a transversal. This one, this and this are the corresponding angles. Clear? Now let's come to alternate interior angle. Now which are the alternate interior angle? This and this. Means, I mean this number 4 and number 5 angle, because both are interior angle and they are alternate. Alternate means you can't say opposite. Opposite means this side. Alternate will be on the same line on the opposite sides of the same line. Understand that way. So, it will be 4 and 5. Clear? So, alternate angle. Interior alternate, okay, I'm writing INT for interior alternate angle, will be angle 4 and angle 5. Now if I ask you this angle 3 and angle 6 also will be the interior alternate angle, because see this is also inside. So angle 3 and angle 6, this also will be the alternate interior angle. Now what if the pair of alternate exterior angle, exterior, I'm writing EXT, alternate angle, what will be it? Number 2 and number 7, isn't it? This is an exterior angle, see this is an exterior angle. And this is also an exterior angle. And on the transversal line, they are on the opposite side. So, these two are the alternate exterior angles. So, angle 2 and angle 7. Again, this angle 1 and angle 8. Clear? Angle 1 and angle 8. Okay? This whether now pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal means they are the interior angles, but they are on the same side of the transversal. We have read the interior angles, they are on the opposite sides. Wait. Wait a minute, I'll just, now this thing you have marked, you have known interior angle, number 2 is exterior angle, number 3 is pair of corresponding angles, number 4 is a interior alternate angle, number 5 is interior exterior alternate angle. Now we will be doing number 6, that is pair of, here we have to write interior pair of, or pair of interior angles, pair of interior angles on the same side of transversal. Here again I am drawing the picture to make it clear here. Now tell me what are the interior angles? This angle and this angle, this angle and this angles are the interior angles. Now you will be having pair same on the same side. This will be the same side, and we have marked it as now angle 3 and angle 5. So pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal will be 3 and 5, and this we have marked as, you see, 4 and 6. So 4 and 6, so it will be angle 4 and angle 6. Okay, so these are the different angles formed when a transversal cuts two lines. Clear?